Hello everyone. I would like to thank you for participating in this online meeting. My name is to present you the INCREASE project, which is an Erasmus project focused on the enhancement of intercultural competences of adult educators. As adult educators in at Emphasis, I would like you to share with us some experiences, some tips, maybe some good practices you're applying during these trainings. First of all, introduce yourselves.
Hello, my name is Telios. I'm a project researcher at the Emphasis Center.
Hi there, I'm Andriana. I also work at the Emphasis Center as a project researcher.
Hello, I'm Dimitra. I'm a project researcher and an ICT instructor at the Emphasis Center.
Hello, my name is Cristalla and also I work at the Emphasis Center as a project researcher.
Before we start, I will tell a few words about the Emphasis as a research, educational research and training center in general. We provide training opportunities for various adults with different backgrounds. One of these is adults with disadvantaged backgrounds, such as asylum seekers, low-skilled adults, and people looking for jobs. Through our one-stop support center, we try to provide opportunities to those people to make this transition from a different country to our country and in the job market as smooth as possible.
Yeah, I think we've got together a really great group. But in order to find these people, we actually did a lot of calls we made to the UNHCR to help you have refugees in Cyprus. So we got in contact with various organizations in Cyprus, and we managed to also organize an info day. The purpose of this info day was to collect as much information, as much feedback as we could on these potential participants. So we wanted to understand like what their needs were and how we could address them. We didn't want to just say, okay, this is just like a standard course. We wanted to tailor it exactly to their needs. So we did a questionnaire. We're asking, what do they know and what would they like to learn? What would they like to get out of this? And we took it from there in order to develop it.
So an icebreaking activity in the beginning of the course is important to warm up the conversation between the participants, to get to know each other and to get to know the trainers and to build interaction. Also, it's important to organize some cultural activities to let them introduce themselves and their culture and let them share their stories, ideas and experiences.
Yeah, exactly. This is what we do in order to create a friendly environment. As an ICT instructor, I would like to share with you some tips that we use in the class. It is very important to use simple English. This is not the time to show off your vocabulary. You have to downgrade the level of your English and you have to use simple words. It's also important to speak loud and clear. So if you want to emphasize a few key points, make sure that people realize which are the key points. If it needed, you have to repeat them using different phrasing. There is no need to rush. You can also vary your voice quality. If you always use the same volume and pitch, for example, all loud or soft, your audience will switch off. This is also a very good tip that you can use as educator. When you begin with a new point, use a higher pitch and volume and make sure that you make pauses and during your lecture. Don't be afraid to make a short periods of silence. In that way, you give the time to your audience to think about it. And if they have questions, you have to let them interrupt you. let them ask you questions in order to ensure that they can understand and they can follow the lesson. You can also use your body language and make sure that you have an eye contact. You have to have the control of your class and you have to look around and have an interaction with your audience, with your learner. If you don't include your audience, they won't listen to you. So try to interact as much as possible. This is what we usually do, and this is what we recommend you to do in the class. Of course, as a training center, we always try to enrich these trainings, and we organize some outdoors activities.
Yes, of course, as Dimitra said, we organize some outdoors activities, such as visits to various Cypriot companies, such as Antenna, which is one of the biggest media stations in Cyprus and Greece. And we organize a tour to their headquarters, also a visit to Omodos Village for a wine tasting to the Omodos main square, so they can try traditional food. And as Emphasis Center, we participated in the Cyprus International Education and Career Fair every February, which is located in Nicosia in Cyprus Expo. And the participants, they can visit us in our booth so they can build their network and they can identify professional development opportunities.
Thank you, Kristalla. That's very interesting. Another activity I would like to share with you, it's during the training, it's very important to organize something after the class has ended. An example of this kind of activity is intercultural night, which I did organize it a lot of times as a Key Action One trainer. The purpose of Intercultural Night is for each country to present their country, their location on the map, their customs and traditions, their some fun facts, some myths and legends. After the presentations, we organize a mini food festival where each country presents their traditional food. So I find this activity very important because within a group, people have the opportunity to meet another country more deep and to try traditional food from other countries.
I would also like to add that through this process, it's not just the participants that they are gaining from us through gaining new skills and acquiring new knowledge. But as a trainer, we are gaining as well. We are keep developing because we are pushing ourselves to find new ways to interact with them and make our sessions as interesting and educational as possible. So I would say it's a two-way process that we are benefit from it as well.
Yeah, I totally agree with you, Stelios. It's a very rewarding experience as well, especially when we get the feedback and, you know, when they let us know that, hey, you know, I found a new job. Thank you so much. So all of this feedback we have from them is and their continuous support is so important as well. We've even had people who have tried to, you know, promote their own work throughout other social media through creative portals that Kristalla managed to do the session of Dimitrat, who taught them how to build, you know, their CVs and how they've managed to move on and how useful these trainings were for them. So for us, it's very rewarding and we feel very proud as well, I would say.
Exactly, and this is what we recommend to other adult training centers. Mm-hmm. They have to find a way to offer support and help to these people. So what we did, we established these support centers in our training center, and we organize now weekly sessions in order to be able to keep offering support and guidance to these people who are in need.
Thank you, Dimitra. So we can conclude to the fact that language a different language and culture are common difficulties, and that is good to in the classroom to you within the cultural learners to use simple English to speak loud and clear, to ask questions, to repeat many times as you can, to use your body language, and also to organize cultural activities and let them to introduce you to their culture and tradition. Do you have something else to add?
I would like to add that last for me, another tip is to show respect to the people you are engaging with, because you don't know their stories and what they've been through to be here. So it's always advisable to show respect, and there is a lesson in this interaction for everyone, even for us.